I might be a TEDx speaker now, but it wasn't all that long ago that I suffered from terrible anxiety when it came to giving speeches, even in front of small audiences. Now I use a technique called the Memory Palace, which has been scientifically proven to create positive brain states that can reduce stress. Since learning to use this ancient memory technique, I have given talks from memory around the world, including in other languages. And in today's video, I'll teach you how, with examples from myself and others. We'll take Jonathan Levi of Superlearner fame for one example, and the Memory Palace he used to give his TEDx talk at my suggestion and with my help. In both my talk and Jonathan's talk, which involved verbatim memorization to make sure we were on the mark for time and focus and delivering ideas worth spreading, the Memory Palace technique and some special ingredients we'll dive into was the key to success. Of course, you might be saying, oh, but you and Jonathan have been using memory techniques for years. How do I know what you're going to teach in this video is going to work for me? Well, here's what Michael DeLeon wrote me recently to say after just a few weeks in the Magnetic Memory Method Masterclass. I've been training myself in the techniques of the Magnetic Memory Method. I've given two speeches that were by far the easiest for me to give because of the Magnetic Memory Method. I felt no pressure. I could relax and deliver the speech I wanted to give because there was never a fear of I would lose my place. So like Michael and Jonathan, I humbly suggest you focus on the steps, don't overthink them, and put them into action. And if you're new here, please consider getting subscribed to this channel, hitting that thumbs up, and completing this simple warm-up exercise to start engaging your imagination for better memory now in the comments. Where is your dream location to give a speech? Austria? Italy? Japan? Any place goes. So dream big and let me know what you want to speak about. My current dream is to speak at the Metropolis Kino Hamburg in Germany and give extended talks on movies and memory, my two favorite topics. Call it nostalgia, but I miss giving talks in Germany very much. So, when this exercise is done, let's dive right in and take a look at how to memorize a speech and how the memorization process itself can help you feel incredibly confident and relaxed while speaking anywhere in the world. Writing a good speech is shockingly not obvious to a lot of speakers. And believe me, I've waltzed into rooms and talked off the top of my head or otherwise been minimally prepared. It rarely comes off well. But if you want a million views or more on a talk like I've been able to achieve, script your talk. Now, I used to be a film studies professor who specialized in narrative and narratology and also worked for a while as a story consultant on movies that actually got made, so I know a modest bit about crafting a story. For example, I started this video with a small personal revelation. Were I to continue the story in a speech, I would tell you about how my problems with anxiety and speaking started during a time I needed to take medication for manic depression that made my hands shake really, really badly. I'd talk about how at the end of my BA in English literature, every student was required to give a speech. I'd include how after a long crawl back to something like normal, after a prolonged hospital stay of 3 months and a 6 month mindset battle to get myself back to university after the horrible embarrassment a very public manic episode creates, this speaking assignment was the last thing I needed. My hands shook worse than this new normal of jitteriness created by the meds just thinking about shaking in front of this university seminar. When I practiced giving the speech, my papers rattled in my hands and I couldn't concentrate on my delivery, much less express my familiarity with the topic at hand. Instead, I ended up frustrated and even more embarrassed. It was one of the most horrible moments of my scholarly career to be shaking so badly and yet have so much to say. There's more twists and turns to the story I'd put into a full speech, but suffice it to say that this excruciating experience led to a fear of giving speeches that lasted for years. If I hadn't learned the Memory Palace technique and experienced its calming benefits, I never would have become a professor and never enjoyed the bliss that comes with being able to speak in front of audiences all over the world. If you want me to say more about the speech writing process in a future video, please let me know loud and clear with your comments, and if we get 1,000 thumbs up, I'll take that as a signal that we should make that happen for you. The larger point is that writing a good speech is its own skill, and once you've done so, you're really going to enjoy the next step in the process because of how it makes memorization so fast and easy. All you need is one secret ingredient known to our ancient ancestors very well. If I've said it once, I've said it 1,000 times. Preparation is everything. Preparation is the secret ingredient that enables survival and ensures we experience growth as we master new skills like public speaking. If you're already part of the Magnetic Memory Method world, you know that preparation starts with drawing your memory palace. This step is key. And that's what I encouraged Jonathan Levi to do when we recorded a private coaching session and showed him just how much simple hand movements make your memory palaces bulletproof. Judging by how successful his talk has been, I'd say his use of the technique was bulletproof indeed, if not superhuman. But here's an important point you don't want to miss. I said memory palaces, not memory palace. If you want to master this skill, especially for the express purpose of speaking, make sure that you create and use more than one, so your spatial memory can really switch on. Maybe some people can become memory masters with just one memory palace, but I think that outcome is quite rare. To be clear, I use the term memory palace, but I'm actually talking about the Magnetic Memory Method, where we use the memory palace as part of a process that is more robust than the technique is normally taught. In the Magnetic Memory Method family, we have a number of special lists that allow us to rapidly draw upon pools of associations. These are important because they save us tons of time and mental energy. We don't have to be creative and hum and haw, as we've seen many other memory training books and courses cause people to do. The lists that I recommend my students create are fun and easy, but there's no getting around the fact that it takes a bit of preparation. If you look into the science and historical development of these techniques, I'm confident you'll soon see that everybody thinks already in lists, but most people just haven't optimized the process. But once you do, when you have skills with the memory palace technique and you're ready to memorize, the process looks like this. I take the first line of the speech and I bring the memory palace to mind. Then I look at the words, the letters in the words, and like a human search engine, reach for or call up the associations that have been pre-prepared during the process of creating the magnetic lists. For example, the talk starts with the words, how would you like to completely silence your mind? How sounds like part of Howie Mandel. So I put this actor, who has been living in my memory for most of my life, on the first station of the Memory Palace journey. There's a next level tip for you. The more you choose associations that have already been living in your memory for a substantial amount of time, the more powerful they will naturally be. This isn't strictly necessary though. For the TEDx talk I delivered, I used a neighborhood I've lived in only for a short while compared to others I've used. In this case, instead of just an ordinary sidewalk, I injected Howie Mandel so he was standing there with the like thumbs up button, like the one you should hit right now if you're enjoying this free memory training experience. Howie plus the like button is enough to trigger. How would you like? In terms of the words to and your in the phrase, images for these were not necessary. But if you needed them, provided you have prepared yourself, it should be easy as pie to add something like a tutu for two. But typically the logic of language helps you fill in the gaps. In fact, for some of the sentences in this talk, there were 17 words encoded that required just 3 images on one station. To get to that level, you should expect to not only prepare in advance, but also practice. There are certain tools of compression and what we call magnetic bridging figures that can really pack things in tight. And in order to get the speech itself into long-term memory once you've encoded it with your magnetic associations, you need step 4. To practice from the memory palace, I suggest a process called recall rehearsal. This is going to strike some people as crazy or too much work, but in reality, I think rote memorization is the real crazy thing to be doing, unless of course you enjoy it and it works for you. For me, rote memorization is way too much work, so clearly the status of this technique is in the mind of the memorizer. I'd rather go through this process 2 to 3 times and be done with it than hammer the same thing at my brain dozens of times when there are so many other fun things to be doing in life. Here's how it works. Then I'll tell you why it works so it no longer seems as insane as it admittedly sounds. You decode the images you use to encode your speech forward. Then you revisit them backward. In this case, I did not recite the lines backward, but each line backward in reverse order. Then start the speech in the middle and move to the end. Start at the middle a second time, but this time in reverse order back to the beginning. Finally, skip the lines in your speech. In other words, recite line 1, then 3, then 5, and so on, and then backwards. For good measure, also write the talk out at least once by hand, and as a pro tip, I highly recommend reciting it at least once while on a walk. This was something Thomas Kraft from Presentation Boss suggested to me, and you can listen to our full conversation about his expertise on the Magnetic Mary Method podcast. Think back to how giving speeches used to make me feel. Sweaty, queasy, shaking just to think about stepping up on stage. Now think about how confident and powerful you can feel standing up on stage as you deliver your expertise to a rapt audience. If I can get there, you can too. In fact, this outcome isn't just possible, it's probable. All you have to do is follow the tips and techniques in this video, and before you know it, you'll be a cool and confident public speaker. If you're interested in the research showing how and why the Mary Palace technique helps create a better brain state, check out the work by Dr. Tim Dalglish, just one researcher in this area, who has also found it helpful for people dealing with depression and in recovery from PTSD. Here's a final tip. Give a number of speeches, even if it's just to a small audience or a close group of friends. This simple practice will help develop your speaking skills, and try different formats. Recite from a piece of paper, do partial recall from memory with limited notes, speak verbatim from memory, or any way you prefer. Whatever you do, have fun with it. And if you want to use the techniques we've talked about today, I acknowledge that it can seem like a lot of work to people who are new to the practice. But that's a mindset issue. This approach is actually like playing a giant and very satisfying brain game, all while delivering value to others and setting yourself up as an expert in your field. If you're still feeling uncertain, there are a few other approaches for memorizing speeches along with examples on the Magnetic Mary Method website and podcast. The link for that resource is in the description. And as always, I suggest you start with the free course at magneticmerrymethod.com/YT first. And I thank you and our regular channel members for the view. So what do you say? Are you ready to get out there and give your first speech from memory? Keep us posted on your progress, and I hope to see you speaking from memory very soon.